Alison Waits is in the studio to talk real estate. Hello.
Good morning, Damo.
So what should we be doing when we're ready to move out of a property?
Yeah, so if a tenant's looking to move out, so if they're still on a lease, there's a break lease fee. That's changed in 2020 to make sure that tenants aren't hit with a huge fine now, which is either 6 weeks or 4 weeks rent. Now it's changed every quarter. It goes down from 4 weeks down to 1 week, and you don't need to give notice for that. But if you're coming to the end of the lease, the best thing to do is give your 14 days notice. If you're out of a lease, which is called a continuing, is 21 days notice that you need to give the agent or the landlord.
So when you say continuing, So if you've got a 6 month lease
and that's expired,
yep,
it just rolls over to a continuing.
Okay.
So same rules apply, except for the vacate amount.
Right. So if you're in the continuation of the lease and you want to leave, you've got to give
21 days notice. It's not a month to month, like some people say, or day to day. 21 days notice. If an agent or the landlord would like to terminate, it's 90 days. So it's a big difference.
Yeah. Okay. So the tenant actually sort of is on the upper there. They get the...
Yeah. So it's better for fair trading. They look after the tenants. So it's better for the tenants. So they know they've got time up their sleeves. Yeah. So what you do is you give your notice, like we just said, and then the agent should tell you how much rent is due up to your vacate date. For example, 21 days. It could be, $1,000, whatever. And then the agent has to ask the tenant for what day and what time they would like to have the vacate inspection, like we just spoke about, and they should be going with the tenant. It actually is in the legislation that both parties should go together.
And is that to make sure that, they're on the same page?
They do, yeah. So the agent, and I always suggest to tenants, make sure you take your ingoing report with you, the one that you've got 7 days to return after you've moved in, because there could be things like maintenance or, damages that the agent did not pick up. So make sure you do that and take that with you. So the rules are that it has to go back to ingoing state minus wear and tear. Which is, we've talked about wear and tear before, but we might do that again another time. Like a bit of a dint on the corner, that's by accident, that's wear and tear, so that's okay. The blinds are getting old, the screens on the windows, they're fading, that kind of stuff's wear and tear. It's not tenant's damage. So as long as that's happened, so definitely go over the ingoing. You can't be asked to go above that. If you did not have any pets, the agent cannot ask you for a bond clean and they cannot ask you for a professional carpet cleaning done. That rule changed.
Wow.
So you can't ask for that unless there's a pet agreement in place.
So if you're in a lease and you don't have any pets,
yep,
you don't have to get your carpets cleaned?
No, unless you damaged it, obviously,
yeah.
And
yeah,
dirtied it.
Yeah.
But no, they cannot ask you that, and they cannot ask you for a bond cleaned either, as long as it goes back to the ingoing state and a reasonable attempt. Which means if you've done you've done a fantastic job, and you can see if you've done a job, it's not just left it dirty.
Yeah.
You've done a reasonable attempt.
Oh, so many times I've wasted money getting someone in to clean.
Yeah, definitely.
Because we've tried to clean it, but then we're thinking, it's not probably up to standard.
Yeah, as long as it goes up to your ingoing report. So if you were given, say, the worst one is window tracks full of dead bugs, flies, dust. If you were given it that way, it has to go. It can be given back that way. So that's why you suggest to landlords, if it's a new rental, have a cleaning done, have a bond clean done. We do that, and then we send the invoice off to the tenant, not to pay, obviously, like the new tenant, but just to show that that was done, and that will reflect the ingoing report. So you just got to make sure that the agent does invite you. If you don't want to go, the agent can go by themselves, but they've got to send you an outgoing report and to say, here's a list of things that aren't up to scratch, which then has to rectify the ingoing and any maintenance, things like that. But if there's no pet agreement, like I just said, they can't ask you for carpet cleaning. But if there is a pet agreement, you have to have the flea spray done professional. You can't do it yourself. It's got to be professional. You do get some tenants that go, I'll put bombs. It doesn't work. And also professional carpet cleaning. So I always suggest get your invoices and give them to the agent too, because you really want your bond back.
Yeah, I was just going to say, in regards to the bond, if you do everything that the agent asks you to do, how long is it before you get your bond back?
So if you've done it online, literally within 1 to 2 days, which is fantastic. We've had some that's been, overnight. So as long as you're paid up to the vacate date, so always ask your agent or your private landlord, how much do I owe to that day? If you think that's correct, fantastic. Pay for that straight away. Make sure you've got your invoices. Make sure the property is clean. Then the agent or the landlord will do a final water meter reading. They take a photo of the water meter and they'll charge you $2.59, I think the kilowatt is right now, or $2.69, and they'll charge up to that date.
Okay.
So pay it all and you'll get your bond back.
Fantastic. All right. Well, that's a because I mean the bonds are the expensive
that's
thing.
4 weeks' rent. That's a lot
exactly
of money.
Right. And you may be waiting to get that back to move into your next
property. Yeah, because you can't. Well, you can transfer it, but it's very rare.
Yeah. Yeah. And of course, if you want to get more details, you can always go to tenants.org.au to get more details of all these different things that we speak about. Our house in the middle.